says you do, and so do I. That's why I'm here to talk about today's sponsor, Morgan & Morgan. When injured, you deserve compensation. When it comes to selecting law firms, size matters. You can check out Morgan & Morgan, America's largest injury law firm with over 100 offices nationwide. 800 lawyers and counting. They've got the resources to fight to get you the best results. And Morgan & Morgan is not a one-lawyer-fits-all case model. Injury cases can span multiple different case times, ranging from car accidents, slip and falls, workplace injuries, medical malpractice, nurse or home abuse, or even defective products. Morgan & Morgan has attorneys who focus solely on every area of personal injury. Plus, Morgan & Morgan's fee is free unless they win your case. No upfront costs, no sign-up fees. All of the calls, investigations, meetings, times, texts, and effort put into your case is completely free unless they win your case. And Morgan & Morgan has recovered over $13 billion for their clients. They fight to make sure that you get full and fair compensation. Over 3 million people trust Morgan & Morgan and call them in their time of need. Their staff is dedicated to make sure that your experience is as painless as possible. Getting started is easy. Just click the link in my description down below and go to forthepeople.com and use my code or dial #law from your cell phone. Let them know that I sent you. That's why I fight for you, Albuquerque. Better call JoJo. Sound assortment. Something simple, short, sharp, to the point. So, yeah, I'm really excited. I haven't really felt this excited to film a video like this before, so I really hope you enjoy. Hope you find it relaxing. And if by any chance you enjoy it as much as I am, let me know by giving me one of these. Let me know if you enjoy it by giving the video a like. It really does help out immensely. Like I said, it's late boy hours. My body clock is officially fried, so I'm just going with the flow at this point. Alright, well, why don't we get started? this is such a funny sounding trigger. It sort of sounds like a vortex is around in your head. And so maybe you can take this moment to fluffing up your pillow, grab a glass of water. Wind down, and most of all, just have a good time. Maybe take a moment to reflect how your day was. Was it a good day? Not so good day? What you did today? Did you get that project done? Did you go to work at school? Finish that assignment, that exam? Some more videos. myself going to sleep very late, and well, waking up very late, which I don't really mind, but I don't know, I'd like to wake up earlier, but I can only really ever comfortably film late at night, which, because I haven't soundproofed my place, so it is what it is, but hopefully you can sleep a little earlier than I can. But I still definitely prioritize getting 7 hours of sleep at least. 8 hours ideally. So just relax, we're gonna send you to... We're going to take you now on a little vacation to... Bubble Wrap Heaven. Sounds with this here green tube. Allow me to demonstrate.
Thank you. sounds like a volcano, but not really. It's like a squishy volcano. It's that time of the night where I start saying nonsense. Let's go ahead. Actually, no, I'm not gonna take 10 deep breaths. Otherwise, I'll fall asleep on camera. Okay. So, next up. Sleepy in it. So yeah, Bubby the Pufferfish, and he's just here to make a quick little cameo, just to say hi. It's been a while since you saw him, so he just really wanted to check in on you, make sure you were doing okay. So you conversation to talk to you guys so I don't fall asleep. This weekend I'm going to a Nationals Yu-Gi-Oh! Tournament. Kind of exciting, I guess. For those of you that aren't familiar with Yu-Gi-Oh! You can sort of consider this as, well, rambling. But actually, I find that if I have no interest or understand what someone is saying or a topic that they're talking about to me, I'll just doze off and go to sleep. So, hopefully, if you're not interested or have any understanding about Yu-Gi-Oh! And don't really get what I'm talking about, you'll fall asleep to the mumbo-jumbo nonsense I'm talking about. So, I'm playing this Yu-Gi-Oh! Deck called Gashtira. Kind of a weird name, right? But it's one of the strongest decks at the moment in the game. And, well, I'll be playing that at this tournament. And I'll be, having a good time there. So that'll be fun, I suppose. And aside from that, I'm just cracking back, chilling out with the boys. So I should be getting really excited for it. And looking forward to that tournament. It should be a good time. Feeling decently confident about my deck. So hopefully I'll do pretty well. We'll see. Only time will tell. Started raining again, which, well, it's not great. One moment. I just wanted to remind you all to make sure you're drinking enough water. Oh, actually, something which is pretty cool. While I'm having this little water break intermission, I was at the gym today. Yes, I know. I go to the gym. I know it doesn't look like it. You don't gotta tell me twice. I know. But I digress. I was at the gym. And I was up. Today was back at biceps day. Thank you very much. Anyway, I was doing my workout at the gym, and well, I'm walking past the squat rack, and there are these two ladies, probably my age or something, who were in the squats, and one of them looks at me and just smiles at me, and I have my Raycons in, ironically. She looks at me and smiles at me, and she's like, "Are you JoJo's ASMR?" And I'm like, "Why, yes I am." And it was just really wholesome, really nice. I believe her name was Emma, yes. Emma, shoutouts to Emma, who recognized me at the gym. It's the first time I've ever had that happen. So, that was pretty funny. But yeah, and she was like, "I've been watching you since I was like 16, 17. So, that was really awesome. So shoutouts to Emma, just wanted to give a little shoutout. And if you ever do find a wild JoJo in the streets, come up and say hi. I'm very, you know, always wanting to meet those of you out there who watch my videos. Because, well, you guys are awesome. Unless you don't want to, you know, unless you're a bit nervous, don't worry. I totally respect that. Anyway, so that was a lot of fun. this question a lot because I get to sort of have my own private life, and it's sort of I get to have my cake and eat it too, because I get to have my private life and enjoy things I like and be able to go out in public safely. But I'm not really that, I'm not really famous or much of a public figure. So I don't get recognized that often, and I think it's because so many of you are in the US. I think about only 2% of my audience are here in Australia, so I actually don't get recognized all that often, but it does happen. And I'm so totally cool with that, because I'm quite introverted, and I'm a person who keeps a lot to themselves, you know what I mean? But with that being said, it's always such a honor, and it always really makes my day whenever I run into someone, or then someone on the street comes up to me and they recognize me from the videos I make. And so yeah, it's always really nice. I never really know what the proper etiquette is to interact with them. Like, is it rude or pretentious or offensive for me to ask, like, do you want a photo or something? Because, well, I don't know. Like, I guess it is, right? Rats. Well, look, anyway, just saying, if you ever do see me, a wild JoJo, feel free to come up and say hi. I might actually be going to Canada or Vancouver later this year, so that'll be exciting. Sorry, this has turned into a little bit of a ramble vlog, but when it's 2 a.m. in the morning and I'm trying not to fall asleep on camera, the best way I can prevent that is by safe and sound wherever or whenever you're watching this video. I really do care about you guys so very much, and always am worried about, you know, if you're doing alright. So hopefully you're doing safe and sound in these crazy times. Know is that probably can't see it because it's off camera to the right here, but I bought a brand new piano
7.